Hey guys, welcome back. Happy New Year, Merry Christmas, all of that jazz. It's a new year, which means we're making a goal setting video, obviously. So what I'm going to cover today is setting your goals, the way I go about setting my goals and kind of the process of building that out, and also how to set them up in ClickUp. Okay, so if you have watched any of my previous videos where I go through parts of my ClickUp build out, you will know that previously I was using just a list format to plan and track my goals. But this year, I have decided to try out ClickUp's actual goal setting feature that they have. So that's what we're going to do. To find that feature, it's located over on the left-hand side. Here you'll see it's got a little trophy icon that says goals. You can just click that there and it will bring you into this goals section. So before we dive into building that all out in ClickUp, making it cute, making it pretty, all those things, we need to actually set our goals. So the first step is coming up with a goal that you want to achieve this year, figuring out the time frame that you want to achieve that goal in. What are the tangible targets that you're going to be striving to achieve, and then what the minute tasks that you need to achieve to be able to hit those targets. So let's run through one of mine. I'll kind of explain how I've broken that down, what my thought process is when I'm building out these goals. So coming back in here, we'll go into my business. I'm going to jump ahead a little bit and talk about timeframes first, because this really dictates kind of the level of goal that you're trying to achieve. It is great to have like 1 year goals, like what's your plan for the entire year. If you're like me, and that can be pretty overwhelming and very unlikely that you're going to reach them, what I prefer to do is to break them down into chunks. So previously, so last year, for example, I just did mine in quarters. So quarter one, quarter two, quarter three, quarter four for the year. So every goal that I set was for a 12-week period. That did work well, but I just felt like I wanted to break it out a little bit less, if that makes sense. So instead of doing quarters this year, I'm calling them phases, because I'm going to do them in 4-month blocks. So instead of having 4 blocks of 3 months, I'm doing 3 blocks of 4 months. So each goal chunk is basically on average 16 weeks. So that's what I'm working with for my goal setting. I have like rough annual goals, but really I'm just focusing on the goals for this first phase. And you can see I've written it as P1, which just means phase one, which is just the first 16 weeks or 4 months. One of my goals in this first phase is to hit 1,000 YouTube subscribers. Now I feel currently I'm sitting at 330-ish subscribers. So obviously I've got to get 770 subscribers. I feel like at the way my channel is growing at the minute, that's a very achievable goal for me. But to achieve that goal, what do I need to do? Firstly, I need to start posting consistently, because if you've seen anything on my channel, you'll see that there's big chunks of time between nearly every single one of my videos, because I'm terrible at being consistent. But that's what's changing this quarter, because if I want to hit my goals, I've got to be consistent and be pumping out content more frequently. So with that goal, how am I going to reach 1,000 YouTube subscribers? Firstly, I need to be more consistent. What does that mean for me? That means I need to be publishing one YouTube video every single week. That is my main goal. So you'll see on targets, my target is to publish one YouTube video every single week. That's super easy to say, really, but you then need to build out processes, however you choose to build them out, that's going to assist you with that, whether you're going to be batch creating content, whether you're allocating specific days of the week specifically for that goal. So doing whatever tasks are necessary to reach that goal, however it's going to work for you. I personally have built in tasks. So if I come over into my marketing tab, if you want a more in-depth look at how I've set my ClickUp on, I already have a video going through my entire ClickUp process in each one of my spaces. I will link that below and up here for you. But if I come into my marketing, into my YouTube calendar, you will see that I've already sat down and I've mapped out what the next five videos of my channel are going to be, which is great. That's just a planning phase. But if I click into this particular video that we're currently looking at now, you'll see I've set in here subtasks for that YouTube video. So these are all the minute tasks that need to get done to be able to push that video out, to be able to put myself one step closer to achieving my goal. So that's how I've done that. And then I've built in on a weekly basis to sit down and map out when I plan to get all these tasks done during the week. So that is the actionable process that I've set out to be able to achieve that goal. So I'm not just setting goals and hoping for the best. I'm sitting down and I'm working out how it is I'm going to achieve that particular goal. And I've worked off that goal because that's kind of the top tier goal that I've set for myself. I've also set some income goals and some email subscriber goals. But these are pretty much, if you've been around in the marketing or online content space for a while, you'll know that most of your income, revenue, email subscribers is slightly dictated by the amount of actual subscribers that you have. So those are kind of sub goals to that main tier goal for myself. So that's my process for setting out a goal in the systems. But what we'll do now is I'll actually go back out, start from scratch, and we'll create one together so that you can see how this process works. Back here, we're now on the main goal dashboard page. Before we dive in that, I want to talk about the different sort of ways that we can do this. You'll see that I've just set mine up as one singular goal for the phase. I haven't broken my goals down on this top tier section of the goal dashboard. I've kind of bulked mine together. Now that is one way to go about doing it. If you would prefer to go more in depth in terms of the targets on each of these goals, I would recommend maybe building them out as individual goals in this section. So instead of having just a P1 business goals goal here, I could actually take these targets within here and make them their own individual goal with their own individual targets. So you could have publish one YouTube video every week. It could sit out here as its own target. As its own goal. That's an alternative way to do it if you prefer to see everything laid out that way. And if you have multiple targets / tasks underneath each goal, that would be the way to go about doing that. All right, so let's create a goal together. We'll just stick to the YouTube subscriber one that we just talked about, because that will be the easiest one for us to put in here. So to create a new goal, we go new goal. Goal name will be whatever the goal is that you want to achieve. So we want to achieve 1,000 YouTube subscribers. Click OK. Who owns the goal? That will be me. This is more so if you have a team and such that you can dictate whether you want them to see these goals or not. It's just me in here for the minute, so that doesn't particularly matter. Is there a date that your goal should be completed by? So this will be when you want to achieve that goal. I, as mentioned, set mine for a 4-month period, so mine are due on the 30th of April. So that's the date that I'm going to put in. And then a description. You can put whatever you like here. You can leave it blank. It's entirely up to you. You'll see on the one that I had set, my description just broke down the individual goals or the core goals I wanted to achieve, because like I said, I bulked mine together. We haven't done that here, so I'm just going to leave that blank for the minute. And now we have our goal set. So we have 1,000 YouTube subscribers by the 30th of April. And then we're going to go in and we're going to create a target. So when you're building out these goals, you want to think of what the tangible targets that you want to achieve, something that you can actually track. So for instance, like I said, I was publish one video a week. Wow, great spelling today. One video a week. Again, who it is. Now, this next section is where you can choose how you want to track that target, what the units are that you want to be striving for. The options we have are number, true / false, currency, and tasks. So with number, this is just that. It's just you can dictate what you want to achieve. For instance, this is publishing one video a week. We've done the calculations. We know that there are 16 weeks in that period before the 30th of April. So our target is going to be the number 16. That's one way to do it. If you have a task that is either done or it's not, so it's just a one-time thing, you can opt for true/false or done or not done. So if we were to click this one, it doesn't give you any options to fill anything in. It's just going to give you the option to complete that task at any point. This is a great one if you've just got little minor tasks that need to be done as part of a bigger goal, but they don't really have a process behind them. For instance, one of the goals that I have as part of my larger goal, being my income goal, is I need to go in and set up a business PayPal account. Currently, I'm just using my personal one. I need to go in and set up a business one. That's a pretty straightforward task. It's just a matter of signing up for a PayPal business account. So it doesn't really need a list of tasks. It's not multiple things that need to get done. So that's something that I could just put true or false. It is a target that needs to be completed to achieve my goal, but it doesn't have to be multiple things. So that's where you would use true or false. Currency, again, this is similar to a number, and you could use this for your income goals. So you could say that you want to achieve, like I've written, $500 in that period. You can do so, and you can change the currency as well. Now, tasks. Let's talk about this one for a second, because this is a really great feature. However, it may or may not work depending on what you are trying to do. So tasks, what this can do is it can actually link directly to a task or to a list within your ClickUp. So this is an important way. This is why it's important to actually go in and set up the back end of your goals before you build them out in the goal dashboard. I'm going to step away from that one for a second because I have one with that set up, and I'll take you into it and show you in just a moment. But for the minute, let's just set this number to 16. So publish one video a week. So leave that as is. You'll see it says 0 out of 16. Once we publish a video, we can come in here and we can increase the number by one. And you could opt to put in, you know, the link to the video or the video title, just as like a note there, and I could hit save. You'll see that the target has now changed to 1 of 16 complete. And in our timeline, which just is more like a note section or like a tracker of the changes in your goal, it'll show here note video title, so you could say what that video was. Okay, so let's talk about the task/list option within targets. I'm going to take you back into my business goals because I have a couple in here that I want to show you. I have one that's set up, I have two here that's set up as tasks and one here that's set up as a list. One of my goals or my targets is to become an Amazon Australian affiliate. I also have this set up as a task within my marketing tasks within ClickUp, because it needs to go on my calendar, it needs to be set, it needs to be completed. So I have that link to this goal so that I'm not then double handling. Once I hit complete on that task outside of this goal section, it will automatically complete the task within the goal section. So you see here, if I hover over this one task, it's going to actually show me the task here for that particular target. This one down here, create and sell my first digital product. This one is set up as a list because obviously there are a lot of steps and processes that go into building out a digital product. So if I click on this one list, you'll see it says ClickUp Temp TBA. The reason for that is because that's not a target that I'm working towards right this second. I haven't started building it out. I haven't started researching or planning that just yet. I just know that I want to do it. So what I've done in the back end under my digital products space, I have actually created a list. Once I'm ready to start that process, I can just dive in here and do that. And I'll obviously rename this, and it's automatically linked up with my goal here. This list here. So as I start to tick through items on that list, it's automatically going to update the tasks here within my goals, and it has automatically pulled through how it says task 0 of 14 because it has already pulled through automatically the fact that there is 14 tasks within that list. To do that, you'll want to make sure you've built out the list before you build the goal. Otherwise, you won't be able to link it, which is why I've just put a placeholder list. So let's quickly talk about when you wouldn't use that. So for instance, this publish one YouTube video every week that I have here, the reason I've opted to enter that manually over setting it up with a list, because obviously I do have a YouTube calendar list here. The reason I haven't done that is because of that pull through of tasks. Because within that marketing list, my YouTube calendar list here, I have a bunch more things that you can't see here. I actually have a content ideas section that I just brain dump all my content ideas here, and this changes day to day. There's going to be a heap in here. So what will happen is when I go to pull through that list, so let's say I want to use this as my list, it's going to pull through every single task in that list, and which it's going to, I initially did that when I was playtesting this, it pulled through about 89 different tasks. Now, obviously we're not trying to achieve 89 videos in a 4-month period. That's insane. So that's why I opted to just do it manually instead of pulling it through from a list, because I would have had to change a bunch of things in the back end to make that goal work. And I just wasn't willing to do that. So that's why I've done that one as well as the blog post manually, because when you're pulling through those lists, it will pull through everything in that list, whether it's in an active status or not. So keep that in mind when you're setting up your goals for that. And that's basically how I plan to use this goal dashboard for myself for this year. I've also gone in and set up personal goals for myself as well with targets. How this is looking, how this is going to look for me for updating and on a weekly basis is I've actually, like I said, if you've seen any of my videos previously, you'll know that I use what's called a weekly reset reoccurring task, which looks something like this. This pops up on my calendar every Saturday through Sunday, and it automatically repeats every single week. And I've called it a weekly reset. And what it is, it's just a few tasks that I have that I want to get done each week so that I'm set up and organized for the following week. And I've actually updated this to include reviewing and updating my goals dashboard. So this is a repeat task for me that every single weekend I'm going to get a prompt to say, go in and check your goal dashboard. So I'll just go in, I'll update anything that needs to be updated. Any of these tasks and lists down here that are part of these bigger goals, they're going to fall into my review task dashboard section, as well as create my to-do list for the upcoming week. So as part of that weekly reset, I will sit down, I will look at my goals dashboard, I'm going to look at my task dashboards, and I'm going to plan out what I need to get done that week, what day I'm going to get those things done. I'm going to plug them into my calendar so that I'm constantly reviewing and constantly planning what needs to get done next to be able to achieve those goals. And that's basically my process. That is how I'm planning on achieving my goals this year, how I've set it up, how I've set tangible targets and made actionable steps and put processes in place to make sure that I'm working towards those goals every single day. So I hope you found this helpful. Be sure to give it a like, give it a subscribe. I've got more videos coming this year. I promise I will not make you wait 4 months for the next one. And I will see you guys next time. Bye.